You'd go to Soul Train and you'd see black people on the floor, PAs and black floor managers and black directors. You didn't see that anywhere else.
I remember my first meeting with James Brown. He was from an era where you couldn't do anything big unless you had somebody, probably somebody white, backing you. He was so impressed as he looked around the studio. He said, "Brother, who's backing you on this?" And I said, "Well, James, it's just me." And then he passed by me again and said, "Brother, who you with on this?" I wanted to say, "You just asked me that," but out of respect, I would say, "James, it's just me." And then came to me and he said, "Brother, who's really behind this?" And I said, "James, it's just me."
By the end of its watershed third season, Soul Train had matured from a wild experiment to a thriving business, making Don one of the most influential black men in America.
And that ought to do it for you. We thank you so much for joining us.
And a role model for generations of African-American entrepreneurs to come.
I was one of the first African-American guys to put their name on the credits of a television show as executive producer.
This has been a Don Cornelius production.
He was way ahead of his time in terms of the business of show business. I need to take classes from Don Cornelius.